Hi everyone, this is Nick. Today I'm going to show you how to translate your Microsoft form into multiple languages. So I have a very basic sort of museum visitor survey here to the Cat Museum. I just have some little preamble language here, some consent language, and then I have an overall experience rating question, poor, fair, good. I also included an other just so we can see how Microsoft Forms might treat that as a translated field. And then also I have this open-ended question here. So we're going to go ahead and add our translation. Now you will have to have your survey professionally translated. You'll have to get that text, and then we're going to copy that text and put it in. In my case here, we're going to use Google Translate, so don't at me. I am not a native Italian speaker. We're going to translate this into Italian. You can let me know how good Google's Translate feature was for you. So what we're going to do is we're going to go over to, when you're in Microsoft Forms, we're going to go over to the three ellipses here, the More Form Settings. We're going to go ahead and select Multilingual, and then we'll select from the list of languages. You see, I've already populated it with Italian. I'm going to go ahead and delete it just so that you see what this might look like. You're going to see this. Your primary language is English. Additional language, we're going to click on Add Language, and you have a list of all the different languages that Microsoft Forms might support. So we're going to go ahead and click on Italian once we get that. Now, when you do this, this is where I got tripped up a little bit before. What you're going to have to do now is click on the little pencil icon, the Edit Language button. We're going to click on that, and now you get this backstage sort of staging area for your survey where you have the English title and then a space for you to put your Italian translation. And then we have the English verbiage, and then we have the place to put the translated verbiage. And then the same thing with the question. When we click on the question, you can see that you need to put in the question stem, the actual question you'll need to have translated, and copy that in here. And then each of the response options you can do. Now notice that they don't provide an other. And so I'm interested to see how on the back end or on the user end, how will they translate that other field? We'll see that in just a moment here. So I'm going to go ahead and bear with me. I'm just going to go ahead and let's see, we'll just do this one by one. We're going to copy this. And I have my Google Translate right here. I was just practicing with it before. It'll do that. You can copy right there, paste into here. I'm gonna go ahead and copy my consent language there. We'll put that back into Google Translate over here. You can copy that, and then we'll paste it right into here. Same thing with the overall experience rating. We will go back to this, paste it. There's my translation. I'll put that in there. Now for the poor, fair, good, excellent, and outstanding, what I'm gonna do is I'm probably just gonna do this in one swoop here. Poor, fair, good, excellent, outstanding. And then I'm just gonna copy sort of one by one here like this. So I'll just kind of copy this in there and cut that. Paste that. We're gonna cut this. So you can see that depending on how long your survey will be, this may take just a little bit of time. But once you're done, I think it's gonna be easier. It could be a little bit easier on the back end once all of the responses come into a single form. You don't have to download multiple forms and then merge multiple data sets and things like that. Let's just do this one here. And I'm going to copy that. And then it also gives you space for to customize your thank you message. So this is the thank you message that I already have in my primary language. And so we'll just copy that as well. All right, so once we're done, we're gonna go ahead and click on back, and everything looks good. You don't really notice anything right now, but once we preview this, let's see if we click on preview, what will happen. Now you see that we have the language toggle at the top. Now, I think this is a limitation because I'm not sure if I'm a native Italian speaker, if it's the survey is automatically gonna open up in English, or if perhaps I have my computer set to a different language, maybe that will automatically open in your preferred language on your computer system. I think that might be the case. That's what I seem to gather from the Microsoft forum. So right here, we're gonna go ahead and click on the language that I want it to be translated in. And you can see all of our translations are there. I can go ahead and click and look at this. This is how the other option was treated. And then also that little text that Microsoft automatically puts in there for forms, you can't customize that language. It says like enter your response here or something like that. And so that's also going to be translated, that filler text that they have there. And then they have the submit button. So now let's go ahead and test this out so we see what the responses look like on the back end. I'm going ahead and switch over to Italian. You can see the entire survey there is translated into Italian. It's how it, you can see how it treated the other added fields, like the other field and also the enter text here field in the, those open-ended responses. That's what Microsoft sort of automatically generates there. You can't customize that even in your primary language. So that's one of the limitations of forms. But we're going to go ahead and let's just say excellent. And I had already copied a little Italian saying my visit was excellent. So I'm going to put that there. Let's go ahead and submit that. Perfect. Let's go ahead and go back. I'm going to put it in preview mode again. Let's fill it out in English this time so that we can see what happens. Didn't like it today. I'm going to put that in there. We'll submit. All right, let's go back. And now let's go back to our responses tab. You see I have four responses. So I had already put in two different test responses other than the last two that I just did. So let's go ahead. This is your dashboard. Let's open it in Excel and see how that looks. So we're going to go ahead and download that file. The Excel file will pop up, and now you can see that Microsoft Forms will export this data with all of the underlying sort of metadata, the start time, completion time that it normally does, but it also now gives you a column for language. It tells you which language your respondent filled out the survey in. It'll give you all of the response options in the primary language of the survey. So even though I filled these out in Italian, it still gives me the primary language, but then all of the open-ended text, anything that you enter, your user enters, will be verbatim. So if they fill out some text in Italian or that language, that will show up there exactly as they had written it. So that is one way that you can do this in Microsoft Forms to translate your surveys into multiple languages. And again, if you wanted to add an additional language, you just go back to that multi-language tab and click on add a language. And I think according to the Microsoft Forms, it supports up to 11 different languages. So go ahead and give it a try and see how it works. Let me know how you use it and let me know how it works in the comments below. I hope that you like this video. If you do, give it a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video, usually in data design, PowerPoint, and Excel. But every once in a while, I jump over to my other passion of survey design and construction. I hope you all have a great day, had a great time making this for you, and I'll see you next time.